Hello everyone, welcome to TSAT Nipuna Live. I am G. Shailaja from BSc Microbiology, final year, Giriraj Government College, Nizamabad. Today in this video, I would like to explain about endocrine glands and their hormones. First, endocrine glands. They are ductless glands where their secretions are directly transferred into bloodstream. Here we are saying ductless glands. The secretions which are coming from this glands are transferred into bloodstream without help of any duct. That's why we are saying ductless glands. And the secretions of this gland are called hormones. Coming to hormones, generally hormones are chemical messengers and signal molecules which are secreted by the cells of endocrine glands. The release of hormones in a human body is very tiny in amount. The too much release or the too less release of hormone undergo deficiencies and cause diseases. Generally, the hormones which are secreted by the cells of endocrine glands are entered into the bloodstream and passes throughout the body. But they never show their action at each and every site. They show their action at only particular site called target organ. Due to the presence of surface receptors which bind to hormones and show their action. Here are the major endocrine glands which are present in a human body. They include pituitary gland, thyroid gland, adrenal gland, pineal gland, thymus gland, pancreas. In the case of males, they are testes. In the case of females, they are ovaries. Coming to the list of glands which I am going to explain today are pituitary gland, thyroid gland, thymus gland, adrenal gland, pancreas, testes, ovaries, and last pineal gland. Coming to the first, pituitary gland. Pituitary gland is located in the cella turcica of sphenoid bone in the brain. It is attached to hypothalamus by a stalk called infundibulum or pituitary stalk. This pituitary gland is very smallest endocrine gland, which is oval shaped and pea-sized gland. This pituitary gland is also called master gland of the body because being a small gland, it controls overall functions of the body. The 9 different hormones which are secreted by this pituitary gland targets 9 different organs, and this pituitary gland shows its effects mainly on heart, kidney and muscles. As it is controlling major portions and major organs of the body functions, it is called master gland of the body. Here are the 2 lobes of pituitary gland. They are anterior lobe of pituitary and posterior lobe of pituitary. Here is the diagram. You can see the 2 lobes of pituitary gland, the anterior lobe and the posterior lobe. Anterior lobe receives hormones through hypophyseal portal blood vessel, and posterior lobe receive hormones through hypothalamic neurons. Coming to the anterior lobe of pituitary, it is also called as adenohypophysis. Hypophysis means pituitary. This anterior lobe is the outgrowth of pharynx, means it is a pharyngeal outgrowth which is known as Rathke's pouch. It has pars distalis, pars tuberalis and pars intermedia. This pars tuberalis and pars distalis unite to form anterior lobe of pituitary gland, whereas pars intermedia form the intermediate lobe between the 2 anterior and posterior lobes. The hypothalamic capillaries which are present in the region of hypothalamus unite to form a portal blood vessel. This portal blood vessel carries hormones through hormones to anterior lobe. Here are the list of hormones which are secreted by anterior lobe. They are growth hormone, thyroid stimulating hormone, prolactin, adrenocorticotropic hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, and the last, interstitial cell stimulating hormone. Coming to the first, growth hormone, it is also known as somatotropin, which stimulates the elongation of bones and elongation of muscles. It also helpful in protein synthesis and involves in cell division. Due to the deficiencies of growth hormone, they are causing some deficiencies due to hyposecretion of growth hormone. Hyposecretion means the release of hormone in less amount. Due to the release of growth hormone in less amount, the individual occurs with a deficiency called dwarfism. It is also known as pituitary dwarfism, and the individuals are called dwarfs. The symptoms of dwarfism is the person will not grow much tall. The limbs of the person do not grow. The sex organs of the person do not develop. Generally, the person suffering with dwarfism shows 3 feet height. The 30 years old man look like a 3 years old boy. And coming to the hypersecretion of growth hormone, hypersecretion means release of hormone in large quantities in overactive conditions. Due to oversecretion of this growth hormone, the individuals undergo gigantism. It is also called pituitary gigantism, and the individuals are called gigants. The symptoms of gigantism is the person grow very tall. The limbs of the person grow very large, and the person, the thyroid gland and adrenal glands are very active in condition. Here is a picture showing the differences between the normal person, gigants, and dwarfism. The large person standing at the first is suffering with gigantism, and in the middle, the person, a normal person, is seen, and beside the normal person, pituitary dwarfism person is there. Coming to the next hormone, thyroid stimulating hormone. This hormone shows its action on thyroid gland. This hormone helps in the synthesis and secretion of thyroid hormones. They are thyroxine and thyrocalcitonin. Coming to the next hormone, prolactin. Prolactin stimulates the mammary glands to produce milk during pregnancy. It maintains pregnancy by giving negative feedback, means sending negative signals to gonadotropin releasing hormones and stop ovulation during pregnancy. By this way, it maintains pregnancy. Due to the increased serum concentration during pregnancy, the size of mammary glands increases. And this hormone prolactin is also called lactating hormone, as it is involving in the production of milk. Coming to the next hormone, adrenocorticotropic hormone. This hormone shows its action on the cells of adrenal cortex of adrenal gland, which stimulates the cells to produce the hormones called corticoids. They are mineralocorticoids, glucocorticoids, and steroids. Coming to the next hormone, follicle stimulating hormone. This follicle stimulating hormone stimulates gametogenesis in human beings. In the case of females, it stimulates oogenesis by the development of ovarian follicles and the release of ova in the process of oogenesis. In the case of males, it stimulates the seminiferous tubules of testes to produce sperms by the process spermatogenesis. Coming to the next hormone, luteinizing hormone. The function of luteinizing hormone is seen in the case of females only. In the case of males, it is unknown. It stimulates ovulation and it stimulates the corpus luteum and maintains the corpus luteum and help in the secretion of the hormone called progesterone. Coming to the last hormone of anterior lobe, it is interstitial cell stimulating hormone. The function of this hormone is seen in the case of males only. This hormone stimulates the cells, interstitial cells of testes to produce the hormone called testosterone. Coming to the posterior lobe of pituitary gland, it is also called neurohypophysis. As I earlierly said, hypophysis means pituitary. This hypophysis, neurohypophysis is the hypothalamic outgrowth which is having pars nervosa. This anterior lobe receives hormones through hypothalamic neurons. The axons of neurons carries hormones into the posterior lobe. The main point that to be remembered in the posterior lobe of pituitary is this posterior lobe never synthesize or never secrete or never produce hormones. The only function is it stores and regulate the hormones to target organ. Coming to the hormones which are regulated by posterior lobe, there are two hormones. They are oxytocin and vasopressin. Coming to oxytocin, it stimulates uterine contractions. It stimulates the smooth muscles of uterus contract during childbirth, during labor. It promotes lactation by ejecting milk after childbirth, as it is involving in the total process of birth of a baby. It is also called birth hormone. Pitocin, it is a synthetic oxytocin which is given to the pregnant woman. Coming to the next hormone, vasopressin. This hormone vasopressin is also called antidiuretic hormone. The name antidiuretic hormone is given by its function. This helps in the reabsorption of water from the urine through distal convoluted tubule and collecting duct of nephrons. The water is reabsorbed and the urine will become very hypertonic. That condition is called diuresis, hence the name antidiuretic hormone. Vasopressin, because during the condition of diuresis, blood vessels get contracted, which increases the blood pressure. That's why the name vasopressin. Due to the hyposecretion of vasopressin or the antidiuretic hormone, more reabsorption of water takes place and the less water is lost through urine. Then the urine will become very hypertonic, giving a very bad smell. Due to hyposecretion of antidiuretic hormone, less absorption of water takes place. Then the volume of urine increases. Generally, the person urinates 5 to 6 times per day. But during this condition, the person urinates more than 10 times per day. This condition is seen in diabetic patients called diabetes insipidus. This is the diagrammatic representation of pituitary gland, where you can see this pituitary gland is located in the brain. This pituitary gland is located in the brain attached to the hypothalamus by a stalk called infundibulum. And here you can also see the two lobes of pituitary gland which are secreting 9 different hormones. The 7 hormones which are secreted by the anterior lobe and the 2 regulated by the posterior lobe of pituitary gland. This is total about the master gland of our body, pituitary gland. Coming to the next endocrine gland, that is thyroid gland. It is the largest endocrine gland, which is bilobed structure with a butterfly shape. This thyroid gland contains two cells. They are follicular cells and parafollicular cells. In the human embryo, it is developed from the foregut. This thyroid gland contains iodine. During pregnancy and puberty conditions, the requirement of iodine increases. This thyroid gland secretes two types of hormones called thyroxine and calcitonin. Coming to thyroxine, it is secreted by the follicular cells of thyroid gland, which improves growth and stimulates protein synthesis. It also increases basal metabolic rate. Due to the deficiency of this hormone thyroxine, in children, cretinism, and in adults, myxoedema or SIN. The symptoms of cretinism are the child will be in the condition of stunted growth and the face will be very puffy. The skin and hair become very dry. The stomach of the person look like a pot. Coming to myxoedema, edema means nothing but swelling. In the person, total body undergo swelling. Major parts like eyes, lips, tongue undergo swelling. And this person also undergo with extreme hair fall. Here is the image where you can see the child suffering with cretinism and myxoedema. Coming to thyrocalcitonin, the next hormone secreted by thyroid gland, it is secreted by the parafollicular cells of thyroid gland. It shows osteoblastic effect. Coming to the next gland, parathyroid gland. This parathyroid gland is situated behind the thyroid gland in the form of four patches. This parathyroid gland secretes an hormone called parathormone. This parathormone helps in the reabsorption of calcium ions from renal tubule and various cells of the body. This hormone also helpful in the production of vitamin D, and it is also involving in the metabolism of vitamin D. Coming to the next gland, thymus gland. Thymus gland is located behind the sternum in the region of chest. This thymus gland grows during childhood. After reaching certain stage, after puberty, it undergoes atrophy. This thymus gland secretes an hormone called thymosin. Thymus gland is not only an endocrine gland but also a lymphatic organ which is involved in the production of lymphocytes. This thymus gland plays a vital role in immune system by the maturation of T cells. This thymus gland contains cortex and medulla, where the cortex has undifferentiated T cells and the medulla has differentiated and matured T cells. Coming to the next gland, adrenal gland. Adrenal gland are present just above the kidneys, superior to the kidneys, hence the name suprarenal gland. Here is the diagram where you can see the cup-like structures above the kidney. They are called adrenal glands. This adrenal gland is again divided into adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. Coming to adrenal cortex, it has three regions where the each region secrete different hormones. The three regions of adrenal cortex are zona glomerulosa, zona fasciculata, and zona reticularis. Coming to zona glomerulosa, it is the outermost layer of adrenal cortex where the columnar cells are present, and this cells secrete mineralocorticoids which are involving in the homeostasis. Coming to zona fasciculata, it is the middle portion of adrenal cortex where the cells are arranged perpendicular to the surface, and this cells secrete glucocorticoids called cortisols. This is involving in carbohydrate metabolism. Coming to zona reticularis, it is the innermost layer of adrenal cortex, and the cells of this layer are very large when compared to two other regions of adrenal cortex. These cells secrete hormones called steroids or steroid hormones like testosterone. Coming to adrenal medulla, when the adrenal medulla secrete hormones when sympathetic nervous system get stimulated. The hormones of adrenal medulla are called catecholamines. They are epinephrine or adrenaline and norepinephrine or noradrenaline. The cells of adrenal medulla can be stained by chromic acid. Hence, they are also called chromaffin cells. This adrenal medulla secretes and hormones during emergency conditions, stress conditions, any danger conditions. Hence, this adrenal medulla is also called emergency gland, and the hormones secreted by this medulla are flight or fight hormones. Here is the diagram where you can see the kidneys. Above the kidneys, adrenal glands are present. This is the transverse section of adrenal gland where the first layer is adrenal cortex with zona glomerulosa. Next layers are zona fasciculata and zona reticularis. The innermost region of this gland is adrenal medulla. Coming to the next gland, testes. Testes is a cytogenic organ which is helpful in the production of steroid hormones called androgens. These androgens include testosterone, androsterone, epiandrosterone and dehydroepiandrosterone. This testes helpful in the production of sperms in the process of spermatogenesis. The hormones which are secreted by this testes are helpful in the development of male genital organs and show the secondary sexual characters in males, like muscle development and development of beard and mustache. Here is a diagram of testes where you can see seminiferous tubules, vasa deferens, epididymis and rete testis. Coming to the next gland, ovary. It is a cytogenic organ. This gland also secretes hormones like estrogen and progesterone. These hormones helpful in the development of ovarian follicles produce ovum in the form of oogenesis. The functions of estrogen are: the estrogen hormone stimulates the puberty changes like menstrual cycle and the development of secondary sexual characters and the increase of mammary glands. This hormone progesterone maintains pregnancy, and it is helpful in the enlargement of birth canal during labor or parturition. This hormone progesterone also helpful in the formation of placenta, and this way it is helpful in the maintaining of pregnancy. Coming to pancreas, pancreas are actually heterocrine glands. They show both endocrine and exocrine parts. The endocrine parts of pancreas is islets of Langerhans, where the exocrine part is acinar cells. Let us discuss only about the endocrine part of pancreas, that is islets of Langerhans. Coming to the islets of Langerhans, pancreas has 1 to 2 million islets of Langerhans. Each islet has 3000 to 4000 cells. These islets of Langerhans contain three types of cells. They are alpha cells, beta cells and delta cells. Alpha cells secrete an hormone called glucagon and beta cells secrete an hormone called insulin. Delta cells promotes the inhibition of insulin and glucagon secretion. Coming to the beta cells, insulin, due to the deficiency of this insulin, diabetes mellitus is seen. Diabetes mellitus is occurred due to the destruction of islets of Langerhans where the insulin deficiency is seen. This diabetes mellitus is again two types, type 1 and type 2. In type 1 condition, it can be treated by taking insulin injections. In type 2, it can be treated by taking hypoglycemic drugs. Coming to the next gland, pineal gland. This pineal gland secretes an hormone called melatonin. This pineal gland, earlier called as third eye. This pineal gland is attached to diencephalon by a stalk called pineal stalk. This pineal gland secretes an hormone called melatonin from serotonin. This pineal gland generally releases during night times and inhibits ovulation. It also maintains sleep-awake cycles. Now let us discuss what I have discussed in this today video. Coming to the first step, we have discussed about endocrine glands. Here is the human body with major endocrine glands where you can see pineal gland, pituitary gland, thyroid gland, parathyroid, thymus, adrenal glands and pancreas, testes and ovaries. Coming to the pituitary gland, here you can see it is located in the brain and attached to hypothalamus by a stalk called infundibulum. The two lobes of pituitary gland are secreting 9 different hormones. The 7 hormones are secreted by anterior lobe and the 2 hormones are secreted by posterior lobe. The 7 hormones which are secreted by anterior lobe are growth hormone, thyroid stimulating hormone, prolactin, adrenocorticotropic hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone and interstitial cell stimulating hormone. The last 3, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone and interstitial cell stimulating hormone are also called gonadotropin releasing hormones as they show their action on gonads. Coming to the growth hormone, it stimulates the elongation of bones and muscles, overall improves the growth of body. Coming to the thyroid gland, this thyroid gland stimulates the secretion of thyroid hormones. Coming to prolactin, which stimulates the mammary glands to produce milk during pregnancy. And it maintains pregnancy by giving negative signals to gonadotropin releasing hormones. As this way, it maintains pregnancy. Coming to the next adrenocorticotropic hormone, this hormone shows its action on the cells of cortex of adrenal glands. And this hormone, this adrenocorticotropic hormone, secrete an hormone called steroids, mineralocorticoids and glucocorticoids. The next hormone secreted by the anterior lobe is follicle stimulating hormone. It shows its effects on ovum and testes. It stimulates gametogenesis. In the case of females, it is helpful in the development of ovarian follicles and release ovum in the process of oogenesis. And in the case of males, it stimulates seminiferous tubules of testes to produce sperms by spermatogenesis. And coming to luteinizing hormone, this hormone functions only in females. It stimulates ovulation and helpful in the maintenance of corpus luteum and secrete an hormone called progesterone. Coming to the interstitial cell stimulating hormone, this hormone stimulates the interstitial cells of testes to produce an hormone called testes. Coming to the posterior lobe of pituitary gland, this hormone regulates two hormones. First, oxytocin. This hormone stimulates uterine contractions and promoting lactation after childbirth. Coming to the next hormone, antidiuretic hormone or vasopressin. This hormone is helpful in the reabsorption of water through distal convoluted tubule and collecting duct of nephrons. Due to the more reabsorption of water from the urine will become very hypertonic, giving very bad smell. This condition is called diuresis. Due to hyposecretion of this hormone, less water is reabsorbed and more volume of urine is urinated. Here in this picture, you can see the human body with various endocrine glands. I earlier discussed about pituitary gland. Coming to the next gland, thyroid gland. This thyroid gland having two cells, follicular cells and parafollicular cells. These two cells secrete two different hormones. They are thyroxine and thyrocalcitonin. This gland contains iodine, and to release these hormones, there is the necessary of iodine, which we will take in our daily diet. The two hormones of this gland are thyroxine and thyrocalcitonin. Thyroxine improves growth and stimulates protein synthesis. Due to deficiency of thyroxine, cretinism and myxoedema are two deficiencies are seen in a patient. In cretinism, it is seen in the case of children, and myxoedema it is seen in the case of adults. Coming to the next gland, parathyroid gland. This parathyroid gland is located behind the thyroid gland in the form of four patches. This parathyroid gland secrete an hormone called parathormone, which is helpful in the reabsorption of calcium ions from renal tubule and various cells. Coming to the next gland, adrenal gland. This adrenal gland, which is present above the kidneys, is again divided into adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. This adrenal cortex is again divided into three regions where each region secretes different hormones. The first region, zona glomerulosa, which secrete mineralocorticoids and involve in homeostasis. The second region, zona fasciculata, which secretes mineral glucocorticoids and involve in carbohydrate metabolism. The last layer, zona reticularis, secrete steroid hormones. Coming to adrenal medulla, this adrenal medulla secrete hormones called catecholamines. They are adrenaline or noradrenaline, epinephrine or nonepinephrine. These hormones are released in emergency conditions like stress, danger and fear conditions. Coming to the last gland, pancreas. This pancreas, as I earlier said, it is a mixed gland or heterocrine gland. The endocrine part of pancreas is islets of Langerhans. Pancreas has 1 to 2 million islets of Langerhans, where each islet has 3000 to 4000 cells. The islet contain three different types of cells. They are alpha cells, which secrete glucagon, which increases the blood sugar levels, and the next, beta cells, which secrete insulin, which decreases the blood sugar levels. These two hormones, glucagon and insulin, are antagonistic to each other. And the last cells, delta cells, which inhibit the secretion of insulin and glucagon. Coming to testis. Testis is a cytogenic organ which release steroid hormones called testosterone. This testosterone is involved in the development of secondary sexual characters in males and also in development of male genital organs. Coming to ovaries. Ovaries, in the case of females, they secrete hormones called estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen undergoes puberty changes like development of mammary glands and occurrence of menstrual cycles. Coming to progesterone, which maintains pregnancy and helpful in the enlargement of birth canal and helpful in the formation of placenta. Coming to the next gland, pineal gland. This pineal gland is a small gland which is located in the brain attached to diencephalon through a pineal stalk. This pineal gland secretes a hormone called melatonin, which is derived from another substance called serotonin. This hormone melatonin released generally during night times and inhibits ovulation. This also maintains sleep-awake cycles of body. And finally, I would like to thank Commissionerate of Collegiate Education, and I thank my principal of Giriraj College, and I would like to thank the Zoology Department, which have helped me to perform here, and each and every person who have supported me to do here today. Thank you.